How's it going, everyone?
I'm FeatherGamer555, and welcome back to more Paper Mario: The Thousand Year Door. If you're wondering why I'm starting on this part, even though I was going, in the previous episode I ended earlier without doing an outro, it's because I wanted to actually save this to this episode, so I'm gonna read it now. But I mean, I did read it in the previous episode, and then I did my outro, but I'm like, you know what, we'll just do it all in this episode. So I just cut it out, and it's back in, so. Yeah, it was just better organized if I did it like that, so yeah, I didn't think about it when I was going, I just kept playing, and I kind of forgot I was, you know, making a video, and so I just kept playing. So yeah, anyway, we're gonna do it now, so. Anyway, let me read for you people, because I like reading. Anyway, oh great exalted Grotus, we brought the Princess Peach you ordered, sir. Well, 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 my pet. Isn't it about time you told us where the map is? Princess Peach, you will speak when spoken to. I'm telling you, I don't know. There's no point in trying to hide it, silly girl. We know you have it. We know this. Trust me, it's very much in your interest to be absolutely honest with us. We Exnauts are not all rainbows and lollipops. I assure you, we're quite nasty. Grotus, sir, I have news. Report at once. You know that crystal star we thought maybe Hooktail had? Well, someone nabbed it. What? What did you say? Someone else is after the crystal stars? And he defeated that Hooktail creature, you say? Speak, soldier. Yes, sir. Sorry, sir. There's more, too, see. According to the report, there was a mustache dude in a red hat and blue overalls who pulled the job. Mario? Excuse me, Mario? She said it for me. Juppy, do the dialogue for me. Yeah! I see, so you know of this Mario, do you? This fool matters not at all. I'll know all about him before long. That, I promise. I grew bored of talking. Take Princess Peach back to the holding room. Yes, sir. And then, take good care of Princess Peach. Understand? She is not to be harmed. You got it, sir. Exnauts have the coolest exit ever. Whoa! X. Just make an X. If you're a fan of Big Brother Canada, you can call it the Shield. No, I'm not going there. Well, Lord Crumb. If this Mario character has the map, then it's highly likely he'll find the crystal stars we're hunting in the bog of the woods. You must return there immediately and hasten the excavation. It must not fail. Was that? Oh yeah, sure, Roger Grotus. And with that, pow! I'm gone. That's all, I'm gonna exit something next time. I'm gonna be like, pow! I'm gone. I wonder if sending Lord Crump there alone is wise. He's a bit out there. Excellent, I summon the Shield. Play a little clip of Big Brother the Shield. Maybe, if I can find one. I will do that. Okay?
It's the Shield.
You rang, dude? I mean, sir? You rang, sir? Grotus? Dude? Grotus? Sir Grotus? Sir? Shut up. Go get the Shadow Sirens over here. The Shadow Sirens, sir? But they... I don't care how you plan to end that sentence, fool. Go get them. Now. Gotcha. I'm gonna make fun of this the whole time. The Shield. The Honorable Grotus has need of us, then we arrive without delay. Pray tell, did the princess tell you where the map is? Still your tongue, Belgum. We would already have it if you'd snatched her earlier. But now since you missed your chance, some poor fool named Mario went to the map. It wasn't my fault, truly. There were too many prying eyes there, too many. Besides, a strange old man showed up at the moment of truth, and he had to retreat. Why worry? All we need to do now is find this Mario and steal the map, yes? Indeed, that is your duty. Must I remind you that map is vital to the Exnaut plan? I will have my men prepare all available information on this Mario. For now, hear me, Belgum. Your Shadow Sirens must take care of this troublemaker. Fear not, sire. I, Belgum, shall return with what you seek. Let's go, my lovelies, Marilyn, Vivian. Come, we've got a job to do.
Go.
Shadow sirens. Oh dear, here we go again. I can't believe I'm kidnapped again. Mario and Toadsworth must be worried sick. Again. But, hang on a moment. Where in the world am I anyway? It's so unfamiliar. I wish I could at least let Mario and Toadsworth know that I've been caught. Okay. Well. We get to explore, so what's this way? It doesn't seem to be open. Gosh darn it, doors always never open. Oh, I like playing as Peach. It's just so entertaining. It's just as entertaining as playing as Peach in Paper Mario for the 64. It's the same thing. And I mean, same with Super Paper Mario as well. Peach has always been fun to play as in Paper Mario games. I think that is one of the reasons I'm not a big fan of Sticker Star. You don't get to be Peach that time. Then again, you don't get to do a lot of things in Sticker Star. Oh well. Give me a second. Do you hear that? It's a door. Anyway, what a lovely shower. No soap scum, even. Wow, I wonder if it works. It's too much steam. Too much of steam. Thing, and when I shower, there's steam all over the place too. Because I like hot showers. Because they're hot. How refreshing. I feel like a new princess. She has like a. Oh, yeah, she does. That's cool. And then it's like back to normal. What was that? Hey, how odd. The doors opened by themselves. I can't read. I already did enough of my reading for the episode. Weird, it doesn't look like anyone's around. It doesn't work. How do we keep making these doors open? How odd. Hello, Princess Peach. What? Who said that? Where are you? How amusing. I am right here, before your eyes. I am this laboratory's main computer. I am the Tech XX. Many call me Tech, you may. Sir Grotus created me to be a perfect computer, one that is flawless in its reason. Grotus? Wait, he's that awful dome-headed thing who interrogated me, right? Sir Grotus is not awful. He's a very great person. He is marvelous. Well, I don't think so. But I doubt I'll change your mind, so I'm wondering, why did you leave me in here? I'm unsure. An unusual program deviation occurred when I observed you earlier. My higher brain circuitry malfunctioned and nearly overheated at your image. Also, an unidentified impulse sped through my processors. These events are new to me. There is more to this phenomenon. As well, I ran diagnostic programs. And the solution was, I want to know more about you. I want to observe you. Such a compulsion has never precedence, cause unknown. I, the perfect computer. I couldn't read that one for some reason. I must diagnose this unusual situation. I will not fit. That is why I led you here. Wait, did you just say you want to observe me? To know more about me? Could it be that you... No, impossible. It can't be. You're a computer. What has happened to me? If you know my malfunction, you must tell me of it. Oh, I couldn't really, because... It's just too weird. Please, tell me. Please. I'm the world's best computer. I am perfect. There should not be anything that I do not understand. Please. He's flawless. It's a flawless computer.
Well, you know, maybe. Is it possible that, well, you're in love?
With me?
Love? What is love? I cannot compute this.
Wait, you don't know what love is?
Love, how do I explain? Love tells you when you want to be with a person forever. It makes you feel happy just to see that person happy, smiling, having fun. When you love someone, you will do anything to help when he or she is in trouble.
Happiness? Fun?
I have definitions for these words, but my programming is insufficient. There should be nothing I cannot comprehend. I am a perfect computer.
Comprehend love?
Love's not something you comprehend, Tech. You feel it.
Princess Peach, will you teach me how to feel this thing you call love?
What? You're a computer. Why would you care about the love?
I am perfect. There must be nothing that I cannot comprehend. Nothing.
That is why you must help me understand this thing called love. Please.
If you have any wishes that I can grant you in exchange, I will grant them.
But of course, I am unable to grant such a wish as letting you escape.
What are you, insane? You extroids kidnap me like common Koopas. And then you call me in here and ask me to teach you about the meaning of love?
I should spit on your screen. You'll grant my wishes?
Haha, why should I believe you?
I understand you are angry. That emotion I comprehend. You need not teach me now. But I must learn of this thing. I must. There is no alternative. I must be a perfect computer. That is why if you would just consider feeding me, I will grant your wishes.
Do you understand me, Princess Peach?
Now, tell me your wish.
Are you sure?
Well, okay, here goes.
Can I contact someone? The sooner the better.
Yes, of course you may. Use my communicator to send wireless mail to anywhere you want.
If you so wish, you can use it right now. It is no trouble.
Use the keyboard in front of you. Enter the recipient... recipient.
I hope I said that right. I'm pretty sure I did.
Address and message.
You mean this keyboard?
Alright, let me give this a shot.
Okay, it's ready, Tech. Could you send it?
Email. The message has been sent. For the time being, you may return to your room. I will call you again when I want to ask you something.
Okay then, good night.
Well, that was weird.
Good night, Princess Peach.
That was a weird moment of my life.
It's even more weird when you hear someone walk back and forth in the hallway.
And you're trying to talk about love to a video game.
Oh, jeez. Weirdest moment of my life.
This is why I usually have a fan on. Drowns out the background sound.
Oh, I forgot about these. Oh, jeez. Oh, I love this part. Completely forgot this was a part of the game. Which is weird because it shows in the back of the case, but...
Bowser, the mighty Koopa King, has arrived. Hold your applause, minions. But now that I'm here, kind of you crusty old hag, why didn't you summon me?
Hold your applause, everyone. Don't applaud yet.
Great Lord Bowser, the, crusty hag, Cammy Koopa, will arrive momentarily. I'm really sorry for the inconvenience, but please, wait at the rear for them.
Greetings, your huffiness. The hag, Cammy Koopa, will be arriving any moment.
So the other day, I saw Lord Bowser gazing longingly at a photo of Princess Peach.
You may want to put a cork in it, man.
Whew, I tell you, the look on his face when he was mooning over that thing.
Lord Bowser.
Well, I'm dying to hear the rest of your hilarious story, Mr. Comedian. Do share.
I'm not funny, sir.
He's not funny, sir.
No, I'm sure you're hilarious.
Lord Bowser, I've been training day and night to help you conquer the world.
Should the time come, I shall be ready. Order me as you please, your silliness.
Super, in that case, I'm ready to do some sit-ups, Tubby.
Bowser, you're so mean.
Lord Bowser, please, if it's not too much trouble, head to the rear of the hall.
You say something?
Hail, Lord Bowser.
Bring me the book. I missed.
Oh, I want to talk to that guy.
Ah, Lord Bowser.
Just out of energy getting there.
Whew. I've just now returned. I'm terribly sorry to keep you waiting, my lord.
I bet you are, Kami Koopa.
Now out with it. Why have you called me here?
Please, your grumpiness, don't be so impatient with your poor servant. It's my displeasure to report that Mario, that scum, is off to a town called Roport.
Am I Mario's babysitter? I don't care what he's doing. Are you gonna call me every time that guy blows his nose or what?
Sheesh.
Yes, well, you see, my lord, apparently Mario is hunting for an amazing treasure.
Treasure?
Yes, Mario has gone in search of a star-shaped jewels known as the Crystal Stars. I'm researching just what they are, but there's no question of their high value.
The Crystal Stars, you say?
They sound like good world-conquering tools. I want them.
Yes, very good. Continue researching this for me, you brainy hag.
You.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Leave it to me.
By the way, Lord Bowser, do you like fried eggs?
Yeah, fried eggs are like one of the only kind of eggs I like. So, I'm good.
Do I? I love fried eggs, love them. But, what a weird question, why do you ask?
Well, during my Mario Recon, I stopped in a lovely place called Petal Meadows. I was planning on taking everyone there for a picnic, having some eggs and toast. Of course, I wouldn't think of sending out invites without asking you first, Lord Bowser.
Airhead? A picnic? You moron, this is no time for fun.
See, this is why my evil plans always derail. Because you, Claude, always goof off.
Ugh.
Oh dear, Lord Bowser, please calm down. Remember your blood pressure.
What's that?
What? Is this true?
Lord Bowser, the terrible news. Some bold fool is abducted Princess Peach in Roseport.
Oh, what?
Tell me you're lying, Cammy. How? When? Where? Who'd do such a thing besides me?
I'm afraid we don't have that information quite yet. The investigation's ongoing. One thing is most certainly confirmed, however. The princess has been kidnapped.
Under no circumstances is anyone allowed to kidnap her without my say-so.
I will not stand for this. I'm going to Roseport now. I've got to kidnap her back.
But your grunginess, wait up.
Oh, Bowser.
Oh, I thought I got to do the next part of it. Never mind. I gotta beat another chapter to see more of the Paper Bowser story. Which is the funnest part of the game. Just kidding, no, it's not. It's just way too entertaining for its own good anyway. Oh, I love that.
Goops, my lad, are you telling me that you're going with Mario?
That's right, Dad. I'm going to continue traveling with Mario. And then I'm going to come back a strong Koopa like you, Dad.
Nicely said, young Koops. That's my boy. But always remember this. You are my son, Koops. And I am your father.
Koops, my sweet, I'll be right here waiting for you to prove yourself.
Why did I say it like that?
I don't know.
May I just add, if anything happens, you can always come home, Koops. Don't you ever forget that. This village will always be your home.
Sound like he was getting shed a tear there. Okay, thank you, everyone. Well, I'm off. Sorry to keep you waiting, Mario. You know, farewells. So where are we going?
Let's head back to Roseport.
Remember, Mario, the bearer of the magical map shall unfurl it before the thousand-year door. When this is done, the star shall guide the bearer to the crystal star with pure light. And it didn't stop there. Each crystal star shall point to the next. That's what the book says. Which means, if you take the crystal star we found back to the thousand-year door, so that means the location of the next crystal star will appear on the magic map.
Exactly. Come on, let's go.
Listen. Oh, I thought he was crying.
The scent of this grass has healing properties, I swear.
It just takes me to a happy place, you know what I mean? You think so too, right?
You're a wacko.
Yeah, sure, I'll agree with that. Fair enough. Where's the boy who plays games? I wonder if he's got another game, or is he still talking about Fire Emblem? I'm just very curious. Hang on, my computer looks like it's not synced. It isn't synced.
Oh shoot! How long has it been like this?
Hang on.
It's gonna be black for a second.
Why the heck wasn't it synced?
How long has it been like that? Okay, is it good? Okay, we're good.
I hope it wasn't like that for too long, because I just noticed it now when I looked at the computer. Hey, I gotta say, all I do is play my Nintendo GameCube, best system ever, am I right?
Yeah, I think so too.
Anyway, I saved up for a new game. The sequel to Paper Mario. I just got started, but it's a blast so far. A blast! Try it for yourself and see. I'm playing it.
I'm living it.
Child. Oh, wait, I should save.
Oh, jeez. I'm not only playing it, I'm living it, because I'm Mario.
Oh, I want that badge off. I hate that cricket sound. I understand why Hotel hated it. Flippin' annoying. I don't like it.
Something wrong, Mario?
You're shaking. Are you feeling alright?
Should rock out to this music for a bit.
I think the A button didn't work.
That's a new mailbox SP, isn't it?
Well, neat.
Did you get some mail?
My dearest Mario, I send this letter in the hope that it reaches you safely. I am being held against my will in some strange place. Though I do not know where I am unharmed and in relative comfort. Those who have captured me seem to be after the map I sent you earlier. They may be hoping to use it to find objects they call the Coast Sectors. I do not know what they are planning, but I have a feeling it is not anything positive. Mario, please collect these crystal stars before they do. You must. They're already aware that you have the map, so please be careful. And please, don't worry about me, Princess Peach.
Wow, you got mail from a princess? That's so cool.
So anyway, she's unhurt. That's good, at least. But I do like the sound of those kidnappers looking for the crystal stars as well.
Yeah, well, you know what? They suck and they won't be able to get anything.
Because they're losers.
And they don't know how to get crystal stars.
Anyway,
I missed.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, wait. You're a stupid Koopa.
Here's some star bombs.
I see a Luigi in the crowd.
Hi, buddy.
Hey, Luigi.
Hi, what's up? Do you think I can kill him?
This is why you keep Koops out in your party. Because he can pull off kill.
This is a bounce.
Koops is good, though.
At least to me, it is.
Well, I think there's a badge. Can I, have it?
Give me the badge. I mean, I guess I'll find out after this round, but
give me the badge. Give me the badge. Give me the badge. I want the badge. Give me the badge.
Give me.
You didn't give me the badge, you idiot.
Maybe it wasn't a badge. Maybe it was like an item that does magic. Or something.
I don't know.
I forgot something back here.
How the heck do I get up there on the pipe?
Oh, how did I miss that? I want the Happy Heart badge, because I like this badge.
You got Happy Heart, slowly and automatically restoring HP during the battle.
We're not going to put it on right now, because right now I'd like to have Happy Heart on.
Wait, what?
HP plus, I mean. I want to put half a card on sometime soon. Just not yet.
15, okay. So we're supposed to actually have 15 health right now.
But I'm a cheater and I have 20. Because cheating is good. In Paper Mario.
Alright.
I hate you, game. I hate you a lot. And I'm not gonna try that jump again, but it's just not gonna work.
So look at that, Koops could make the jump quicker than I.
Okay, he couldn't make that one. Back over there.
Go back to Petalburg.
Oh, he's coming. Yeah, the last thing we're gonna do in this episode is we're gonna go and trigger the map, I guess. We're gonna get the next location planned and figured out. That might lead us into a lot of talking, though. Maybe not. I hope not. Boom, 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 boom. Oh wait, I have this skill now. Why was I riding the little thing? That's water. Good go, me. Good go. Okay, what's in? You know what, we'll do the math in the next episode. I'm curious. Okay, can't do that. I know what to do in there, but we can't do it. Screw it, we'll go and do the map. What else do we do? Or at least maybe we'll just stop in that area. No, we can do some sort of talking and cutscene if we have to. If we have to, we might not have to. I can't remember. Oh, I'm sorry about all the slamming sounds. They're the usual sounds that appear constantly. It's okay. Alright, Mario, hold up the crystal star. How do you know to do that? How did you know? You stalking me or something? He can't be stalking me, he's in my party. I like the green one, it looks so cool. I remember the power of this one. Ah.
The location of the crystal star has been recorded on your magical map. You can now go there.
Hey, Mario, look there. The next crystal star showed up on the map. But, I'm sorry, but I don't even have a clue where that is.
I think maybe we should take it to to Professor Frankly and let him look at it. How do you know who Professor Frankly is? Get out of here. Get out of here, Koops. Maybe you are stalking me. I don't know. I'm gonna talk to him and fill them in. See, we're gonna do a little bit of extra reading here. Because it was part.
I see. Crystal clear.
So can you tell us where the next crystal star is or not?
It's in Boggly Woods. The second crystal star is inside a great tree there.
Great tree in the Boggly Woods?
Huh. About those woods, I think some odd creatures live there. If memory serves, there is a pipe beneath town that leads to those woods.
Professor Frankly, you should probably know, it's about Princess Peach. Mr. Mario got an email from her just recently. Irina said that the guys who kidnapped her are also hunting crystal stars. Oh, and she said she doesn't even know where she's being held.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. The Princess Peach's kidnappers are also looking for the crystal stars. What could they hope to achieve? Could the treasure be...
Ugh, too many unknowns.
Unfortunately, the only clues you can rely on are the crystal stars and that map. I guess all we can do is head to the Boggly Woods to find that next crystal star.
Yes, I recommend you do just that, and find it before the princess's captors do. But don't be hasty. If you're low on items or health, drop by the shop and in first. I'll keep researching to learn more about the crystal stars and the ancient treasure. Since I make a plan, Mario do the work, and you just sit in your building and do nothing. Good job, Luigi. We'll read it next episode. Next episode, I promise. We'll talk to him in the next one. Not yet. Although I really want to. Alright, we're gonna save. And there we go. Okay, so that was the episode. I really hope you guys enjoyed that one. I enjoyed it just because I got to play as Peach, got to play as Bowser. And that was the fun parts of it. The walking as Mario was not as entertaining because we didn't really get to do much. We killed a few Goombas. And that was pretty much it, so. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode. If you did, please make sure to support. Hit that like button. Thank you if you do so. Subscribe for more Paper Mario, The Thousand Year Door, and I will see you guys next time when we talk to Luigi. Alright, see ya.